Welcome to the class, students. Today in this class, let us move on to another topic in diagrammatic and graphical representation of the data from your first PU syllabus, that is component or subdivided bar diagram. You have to solve this graph, this diagrams in your graph sheets only or in graph book only. In examination, you may get this type of problem for 5 marks. Let's go for the problems. For the following data, for the following data regarding the expenditure of families A and B represent the data by subdivided bar diagram. Component bar diagram or subdivided bar diagram, both are same. Okay, so this is the data which I have given. It is items, food, what I'll write, expenditure of, sorry, in rupees. Next, family A, family B. So here I'll write the expenditure: food, clothing, house rent, education, fuel, others. So this is the problem they have given. See, in this problem they have given the expenditure of two families, family A and family B, and the items. For this we have to represent this data using subdivided bar diagram. See, first we will take the total of family A and family B. Here the total of family A is, here I'll write the total, that is 8100, and this total is 11700. Next is, we have to represent this using in a graph. First, for this to divide, subdivide. So first, what I will take is, you have to take the cumulative expenditure of the respective families, so that it is easy to divide the data in your graph book. First, I'll write here cumulative expenditure of family A and cumulative expenditure of family B. Directly also you can take this. You can take the numbers and you can show that in the graph. If you take the cumulative, it will be easier. There is no mistakes at all. Okay. So first value will be remain same. You know how to find the cumulative frequencies. In the same way, we have taken the cumulatives. So next, for 2580, we should add 880. And this is 3460. Then I should add to 2200, it is 5660. Next, like that we are adding, it is 6020, 6300, 8100. Here this last frequency is 8100, here also 8100. So this is correct. Next, we have to take the cumulative frequency for family B. So for this also, the first frequency will be same. Next we should add that, and the values are 4600, 7700, 9250, 9700, 11700. So here also the last two values will be same. Now the next step is we have to draw the diagrams, okay, using our graph. Here I'm showing this in a simple way. If you draw this, plot this on your graph sheet, you will get the clear picture. Here I am having two families and it is in thousands. In x axis I'll take the families and in the y axis I'll take the expenditure. X axis this is, here I'll take the families, family, and in y axis, this is your y axis, expenditure, expenditure in rupees, expenditure in rupees. And in y axis I should take the scales. The values or the expenditure they have given in thousands. See here, in expenditures, cumulative expenditure, it is in thousands. So, and the minimum one will be 2580 and maximum is 8100. So, I will start with 0, 2000, 4000, 6000, 8000, like that. Okay? Because here, in a family expenditure B, it is 11700, 1000. Here our maximum value is 11,700. So till 14,000 have taken. Next is I have to plot this. For this, the first I will draw or plot the bar diagram for the total. Whatever the total, here the total is 8,1100. For that to family A. For family A, it is total is 8,100. Here it will comes. So first I will draw one bar. So I'll draw one bar. This is our family A. Okay. Now I'll divide this. First will be 2580. 2500 it will comes here. And 580 almost here it is. Next 3460. 3460 almost here. It is just a rough sketch. In your graph sheet, you will get the clear picture. And next is 5,660. Here 5,000 will come, 5,660. It will be approximately your 6,020. Next 6,300. And last one will be 8,100. It is already drawn. Okay. Next, we have to give the shades for different. We have to give different shades to, we have to write the index and we have to give the different shapes to identify the items. First, I'll give this, you can't give any shades for this, okay. Simply have given different shapes, you can give any shapes. And next we have to draw the bar diagram for family B. So here the total is 11,700. 11,700 approximately it will come here. So this is family B. Okay, so now again we are dividing this. First will be 3,350. 3000 will come here, 3350. Next 4600, 4600. 7700, 7700. It is just a rough sketch. Next 9250, 9250. 9700. and last one will be 11,700. Already we have drawn. Whatever the shapes we have given, the same shape should be carried to this family B also. First, I have taken this shape. So I am continuing this because we have to write this in the index. Okay, at last we have to write the scale. So y axis 1 centimeter is equal to 2000 rupees 2000, and in index we have to write. So I'll start from the foot. This is like this, and next one is so this is, first is food, second one is clothing, next house rent, education, fuel, others. Okay, this is how we have drawn the subdivided bar diagram or component bar diagram. Here scale and index, writing index will also carry marks. Okay, while you are when you are drawing this diagram, immediately you have to show that the different shades in the index. Okay, let's move on to another one. Second one, following data represents the major conception of food grains in Karnataka state. Represent the data by a subdivided bar diagram. So I'll writing this food grains. Next, quantity consumed in million tons. First is jowar, ragi, wheat, rice, and last is total. Here it is a total. So I'll write the values. It is in million tons, the scale 150, 400, and the total. Here the total is 1320. So total is 1320. For this, we have to draw the subdivided bar diagram. Here we are having only one, that is food grains. Okay, so first I write the cumulative values. So the first value will be 450, next 320, it is 770, next 920, 1320, last value is 1320, 1320, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, I should draw this in the graph. X-axis, it is food grain, in Y-axis, quantity consumed in million tons. In million tons. So the values whatever they have given, that is in million tons. So the highest is 1320 and the lowest is 450. So I'll start from 0, 200, 400 like that in Y-axis. Okay, in Y-axis it is 0, 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200, 1400. This is enough. Okay. So in x-axis, it is a food grain. That food grain, the total will be 1320. That bar first I will draw. Here I am doing just approximation. Okay, in your graph sheet you can get this neatly, you can draw this neatly. So now I am going to divide this. First value is 450, so it will come here. Next 770, here it is 700, 770. Next 920, 920. Next it is 1320, 1320 already we have drawn, and I'll give the shades. Here I am giving very simple shades. Whatever the design you want, you can take for that. You can do this. Okay. So here you have to write the scale, that is y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 200 million tons. Next we have to write the index. First one is like this, and this index, the first one index is this, this is your drawer, and second one is boxes, and this is your ragi. And the third shape is, and this is your wheat. And the last one is, this is your rice. So this is how we have represented the given data in subdivided or component bar diagram. Let's move on to another one. Next one, following is the data, following is the data regarding the strength of students of a university during 2008 to 10, construct a component bar diagram. So here they have given faculty, next year. In faculty, here it is 2008, 2009, 2010. So faculties, arts, commerce, arts, science, commerce, engineering, medical. So here I'll write the total. Okay, so this is the data they have given. For this we have to construct the component bar diagram. Component or subdivided, both are same. Okay, so first we will find out the cumulative ones. So first cumulative values we are going to find. Cumulative values for 2008. 2009, 2010. So for 2008, I'll start here. It is 200 and plus 150, 350, 400, 430, 450. Next for 2009, it is 250, 450, 530, 580, 620. And for 2010, it is 300, 550, 650, 730 and 780. So here the total will be 450, 620 and 780. So on the next step is we are showing this in a graph. It's x-axis, y-axis. In y-axis it is years. Sorry, in x-axis it will be years. In y-axis we have to show this y-axis we will take the strength of the students. Okay, so here in y-axis the least value is 200 and the highest value is 780. So I'll start from 100, 200, like that. 0, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900. Okay, here in x-axis it will be here. So first will be here will be 2008. So for that, in 2008 the total is 450. First I will draw this one bar for 2008. It is 2008. Here I am dividing this. First value is 200, next 350, 400, next 430, last one will be 500, 450. Idukke jaasti, okay. So this is how we have divided this, and here I am giving the shades for this. This I will leave this blank only. Next for 2009, the total is 620. So I am drawing that one bar first. It is 620, sorry, 2009. And here in for 2009, the first value is 250. 250. Next 450. 450. Next is 530. Next 580, last one will be 620. So now I should give the shades, the same shades I am following. So this will be blank. Next, for 2010, the total is 780. That is 2010. First value is 300. Next, 550. Next, 650. 730. 730. Now, I should give the shades. So scale I am writing, y axis 1 centimeter is equal to 100 students, and I will writing the index. The first index is like this. This is arts. Second is, this is science. Third will be blank, this is commerce, this is our engineering, and last one is, this is our medical. The engineering, commerce, medical, science and arts. So this is how we have written the index for the given data along with the scale. So this is the problem we are having. This type of problem in examination you may get power 5 marks, that is subdivided or component bar diagram. Thank you.